You're live.
Hello, friends. It is Tuesday, which means it's Tampa Tuesday. And not only that, it's the first Tuesday of the month, which means that it's a Calendar Girl stamp day. So it's the first day that I get to preview and show you how cute Lindsay Ostrom's Calendar Girl stamps are that are going to be shipping this month, which is the July artwork. So we always ship a month earlier. So when it's June, right now, we're shipping the July stamp. So, and I just have my samples that the factory sent me, so I don't have like the finished ones. They haven't come yet, they're on their way, but I at least have something to show you. So I'm really excited. So shout out hello, I wanna hear from you. And you know what, I just love this July set. It might be my favorite set. There's a ton of cute artwork from Lindsay on here. So let's have some fun stamping. So shout out, I'm going to come around and show you guys. Okay.
You guys ready? You can't even see because there's no, this is how my samples are. They don't have the transfer on the front. But you guys are just going to love this.
I like that it's kind of a reveal when you ink it, when we do
it
these.
It is. It totally is. It's a mystery until we ink it. So let's start with the star of the show, the actual Calendar Girl. So she is always almost 6 inches. We keep her so that she will fit on our 4x6 block. Oh my goodness, look, you can see the reveal curls. Beginning. Look, oh my goodness, you guys are gonna love this. Look how cute. Hit the heart button. Who is part of this club and who loves it? Dun da da da. Look how cute she is. And that shading on her dress.
I love the curls.
Oh my goodness. So fun. So this one is our July Calendar Girl. She's holding her cute American flag up there. So, so cute, you guys. Oh, I love it. Okay, let's peel off the next stamp.
One down. I always like counting how many stamps you get on your 6x8 sheet.
Yeah, there's a lot on this one.
It's a ton.
Mm-hmm. There is a lot on this one. Okay, next up, you always get every month, you always get your Calendar Girl, then you always get the saying that corresponds and coordinates with your girl. So this one says, July brings the red, white, and blue and American pride. So there we go. We're just gonna nestle it right next to our girl. Right there. So fun. Okay, so there is that cute stamp. All right, and then every month we also include, let's put that back, we always include a coordinating girl or boy, or the Easter one had a cute little bunny. So there's always some other form of a critter or a person. Look how cute that one is, you guys, with the candles up in her hair. So cute. Not candles, fireworks. And all, look at that dress. Oh my gosh, you guys, she is so cute. Look at that. So, so cute. Okay, so she's on there. Hit the heart button. Okay, then every month we always include the month title. So if you're doing planning or calendaring, you always get whatever month it is on there.
Darlene says, I'm finally able to catch your live show. I love your products. Ooh. The stamps, quilts, stitching, and all of the extra.
Yay, we're so glad you were able to catch us today.
We are currently filming 3 times a week, so there are 3 different times that you can catch us.
Yep. And usually we're always at this time of day, 2 o'clock Mountain Standard Time. Except for Fridays, we started our new segment, which is Freedom Friday. And it is 11 o'clock Mountain Standard Time. Look how cute. So there's the title this month, which, look at that little heart. It is what I'm wearing today, our stitched heart from Lindsay's artwork. So if you love embroidery and you love hats, that's what I have on my head, is that cute little heart right there. Okay, so that is the monthly title this month for July. I think this is the first one we've done that has art attached to it. Usually it's just the title. But that one has that cute heart on it. Okay, now the rest is always whatever we can fit. So like Miranda said, she likes counting how many. So now we'll just see. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 stamps on the 6-inch by 8-inch. So you guys, it's a good bang for your buck. Okay, so this one has this cute block. There's the reveal. Isn't it so satisfying to like add the ink and see what it looks like?
Chris says, you guys have a great job. If I worked at Adorna, I would never bring home a paycheck.
Oh, we do have a fun job. So there's that cute one. Okay, this one I love because you guys know I love banners. Fourth of July. Look how cute that is. Stamped out. So, so fun. Okay.
We have some people asking about how our shipping timeline works for these.
Okay, so it depends on when you sign up. So we ship usually about twice a month. So we ship the beginning of the month for people's cards that go through the beginning of each month. And then some people sign up later in the month, so their billing date is later. So we do a separate shipment at the end of the month. So it just depends on your billing time frame. And if you ever need to adjust your billing time frame, you can always email us and we can help you adjust that. Look how cute that flag is.
Very cute.
So usually about twice a month we ship them out. Okay, now we have a cute Uncle Sam hat in here. Look how cute this guy is. Guys, there's so much detail in these. They're so fun. This is my first time seeing them. Oh, we have some fireworks. So this is the Calendar Girl Stamp Club. So it is a monthly club where you get Lindsay's darling Calendar Girl art on a 6-inch by 8-inch clear stamp. They are, is it $26 a month?
Yep.
$26 a month. That includes your shipping. Look at those fireworks. To get your clear stamp. So that is a great price for all the stamps that you're getting, plus your shipping. So it's included on that. So it's not any additional shipping. So here we have the 3 additional ones. I'm just going to put them all on there. And ta-da! Look how cute.
How perfect.
So fun for Lindsay's cute stamps, you guys. So again, Calendar Girl Stamp Club is where you can go to sign up. So you can enroll today. We usually sell out. We always allot for a few extra. So if you want to sign up, now is the time. But that is that cute stamp set. So it's a 6-inch by 8-inch. So, so fun. Okay. Alrighty, let's look at the add-on stamps. So then we always do, and this is optional to add the second club on, it's called our Calendar Girl add-on. Now, it's a 4-inch by 6-inch stamp, so it's smaller, and it's more based for planners and calendars, because it has some really cute to-do checklists and marks and things like that. But there's also some really cute coordinating artwork on here as well. So this is the add-on stamp. So this is a $15
additional purchase.
Yeah. So, look how cute. So cute, you guys. So, there's a banner. There's always a cute banner shape. There's always these bullet point list makers. So I'll just put both of them on for you guys to see. So if you're into planners, you know exactly what these are. I didn't put ink on that one. There we go, that's better. Look at the fireworks inside that one, guys.
That's a lot of little detail in there.
So cute. So we have those. Then we have this to-do list. So this one's great because if you're like me, you have a long to-do list and you can take and repeat it like that. So you can keep on going and then color in your little stars when you accomplish your task. So there's that one. Okay, then there are a ton of cute other stamps on here, you guys. Look how cute this tall flag is. Oh, I put it on backwards. That will not do us any good backwards. So these are cling stamps, so they cling right to your acrylic block. They're made in the U.S., so they are fantastic quality, you guys.
I love that flagpole.
Isn't that so cute? So fun. So we have that one. This club has sold out the last several months, so if you've been wanting it, snag it. Okay, I'm going to put three stamps on here so we can speed this up a little bit. So Star Spangled Day, a cute little heart, and then this one says Stars and Stripes Forever. Right there.
I love that little heart with the wavy.
So cute. Okay, and then every month there's this cute little banner and she has different art that coordinates. So this month, look how good this one is.
That's my favorite element every month.
Every month.
I love the banners.
So you get, look how cute that is. So fun. Oh, yep, the hearts are flying. It's a cute one. I'm loving the sizes on these. Okay, and then I'm going to take the last three. You get a lot of stamps on this 4x6. Look how many stamps you get.
Jimmy says it's the best club. Well, I do love the stitching clubs, Lindsay Box clubs. Well, everything.
Everything. They're all so fun. It's always so hard to choose. 4th of July.
I don't think there's any way you could run out of things to do or ways to be bored if you follow us.
No, it's so true. We've got the boredom busters. So cute. So that is the 4x6 add-on calendar girl stamp, guys. So cute. So today is reveal day. These will start shipping this month depending on your billing date, but you can watch for these to be coming in your mailbox if you're part of the subscription. If you want to sign up, you can at calendargirlstampclub.com for those cute stamps. Okay, let's color this cute girl, shall we? Look how cute she is. Okay, so I'm going to get my watercolor pencils out. And I need to grab some blues. And let's see, where's my reds? Red. And I'm missing a dark red right there. Let's get a light blue. We're going to need skin color. and some gray. Okay. I think I'm happy with that. Maybe some pink. It might be fun to throw in some pink with this. Okay. Oh, we definitely need some yellows. There we go. Okay. I usually kind of like to pull my color palette of what I kind of want, and that kind of helps me narrow it down a little bit. Okay, so I have it this stamped. I used our Adorna India ink to stamp, so this is safe to use with watercolors. It's not going to bleed. So we're just going to have some fun and color this cute girl, because I just think she's so cute. And the great thing about this club, you guys, is you can choose which skin tone you want.
And hair color. And
yes, you everything. Can customize it however you want.
So you can use the same stamp and then just add whatever twist you need.
Which, how awesome is that, you guys? So fun. Okay, let's make her shirt red. So I want to know what you guys have loved using your Calendar Girl stamps for. Birthday cards, they make such good birthday cards for whoever you're gifting to, because they're so themed for that month. So if you have somebody's birthday in July, this is so cute to give a birthday card that's customized to the month. There, again, we've already talked about it, Calendar Girl calendars and planners. We have Lindsay's awesome doodle planner that this works fantastic for.
This month in particular is great for any of those programs where you write a letter or a card to a soldier.
Mm-hmm. So perfect for that. Okay, so I added some darker red because obviously all your shadowing's over on this side. So I kind of went a little bit heavier and did a darker layer on top of my lighter layer.
Jimmy says she uses hers for monthly scripture journaling.
Oh, yeah, perfect for that.
Donna says I use the stamps on all of my outgoing pen pal letters and envelopes.
So creative. So cute.
Oh, she says my post carrier says I make the postal carriers smile when they see my envelopes.
Aww. I bet you do. I love it. Okay, you can see I'm kind of layering with my watercolor pencils, which you can do, which is so fun with watercolor pencils. You can really kind of, because I did this as my base, and then I did this as my highlight. Sorry. I did this as my base, this is my highlight, and then this one is my shadow on those, which I think is fun. I'm going to do her shoes.
Michelle says, my son is an airman in the U.S. Armed Forces overseas. The month of July is all red, white, and blue.
I love it, and thank you for his service. That is a sacrifice for your family, for sure.
How cute.
Okay. And then we could totally color in different colors, so they were stripes, but I'm just going to make this quick. And I'm going to do the lace yellow to bring down a little bit more yellow down here. Like that. And then I'm going to add in some shadow underneath her. So I'm just going to lightly add some gray in there. Like that. The gray just helps give a little bit of a shadow, which is always nice. Oops, red. Add in some cute red in here. And some blue up in here. Oh, we can't forget those cute little stars up in there. Okay. Let's let her come to life. Let's get our water brush out. like this. And then let's just start. So I just start in one corner and then activate my water with the pigment of the watercolor pencil, and it comes to life. So right now I'm just going lightest over here and wiggling my brush slightly, and then going into my darker to activate that. That will keep my dark really dark by starting at my light. If you start at your dark over here, it's going to pull that out into your lighter. So it just depends on what look you're going for. And I have my paper towel just right next to me so I can dab as I switch between colors. That is the awesome thing about the water brush, is it doesn't stain or pull color. It just makes such a quick way to color your stamping projects. And I'm just touching that. You don't want to mix your colors because then it will bleed together. But, and I love our water brush because it gets such small, tiny detail. Okay, and then let's do our shoes down here. Got our socks and our cute tights right here. Okay, let's activate that shadow. So I'm just gonna touch that and slowly kind of wiggle this away so that it creates just a really subtle shadow in there with that gray. You can see it's just super light, which is what I want. And then I'm gonna have more right here. Just like that. And that is wet, so if I want to, I can go in and add a little bit more color right in there. So really pretty. See, I don't think I activated this one right here. And look how cute she is, you guys. Oops-a-daisy. I did not mean to put red right there. Cute, cute, cute. Okay, I'm gonna do her face. All right, and then she needs some blush. So I'm gonna just take and add a little bit of blush right there and right there. Give her a little pink.
I didn't even notice her cute little necklace before.
Yeah, isn't that cute with the little heart? Lindsay does all the cute detail, that's for sure. Okay, now if I just want to do a wash over the letters, I'm going to take my water brush and I'm just going to add water right here. So that's wet now. And I can just take my pencil and I can just touch where I added water, and it's going to help move that pigment around. So now if I want darker red on this red, I got that wet. And then I can add this on, and it's just gonna add, like I said, a color wash on. So I'm adding water. You can't tell, I'm adding water and then touching it to my brush and moving it around. So again, add some water like that. And then it just puts a nice little watercolor wash on there. I want that to be a little bit darker.
Cindy says, I love watching you paint slash color. It's very calming to me.
Oh, thank you. Well, Carolee and Lindsay are the experts. And American Pride. Let's add some color down in there. Let's add the darker red again. Right in here. So what were to happen, so I did a wash. So if I didn't add water on my paper first, and I did what I just did. It makes it a little bit harder for it to move around. But if you put your water down first, there's my water, and then add your pigment, it moves where your water moves.
There we go. And the light caught that water perfect too.
So that's what I was doing over there, is just creating a wash on top of that.
Donna says, Carolee was great today with Lucy on Lindsay's morning session.
Oh, good. Yes, she filled in for Lindsay this morning. Okay, I'm going to take, and I have this cute art journal book that comes in one of Lindsay's kits. It just has lined paper inside. And earlier I stamped the July on here. You can, do we have her Posca pen? I don't know if we have one open.
I don't think we have one open. I can run and grab
one. Yeah, will you grab one?
Yeah.
And I'm just going to add some red watercolor on here. And we're going to just make a cute little 4th of July book. So see, you can even, it doesn't have to be on white paper. You can even add it onto some craft colored fun things. Like, look how cute that looks. I wonder what the blue will look like. Should we try the blue too? You can only do this if it's dry. So I only put water right where my red was, so that's why I was able to put the blue. Now I'm going to activate the blue. Ooh, the blue looks cool on there too. Look how fun that looks. Fun. Okay, I got to find my paper trimmer. Just a second. So let's see. What did I do with my paper trimmer? Do you know where the paper trimmer went, Miranda?
Is it in one of the drawers?
Thank you. Is it open?
Yes. Oh, that paper is perfect for that.
Yes. So this is from Diana's latest collection. It's this cute gingham color. Let's see. It's 5.5. Right here. A little smaller. Perfect. Okay, I'm going to trim her down. Let's see, to 4x6. So cute. And corner punch. Another, this comes in one of her doodle kits too. I love her doodle kits. Who is part of Lindsay's doodle journal club kits and lettering kits? There has been some awesome stuff that we have curated for those kits to keep in your stash. Let's add some brown around here, some chalk ink. It will match so cute with the craft journal. Like that. Okay, and then this is a brand new Posca pen, so we got to activate it. Okay. So if we were to take and just add a little bit of white in here, look how that Posca pen. Lindsay always raves about her Posca pens, and look how good that and vibrant that shows up.
That's perfect.
Mm-hmm. So we sell these, and they also come in some of her, her doodle journal kits. Gotta love it. All your supplies that you need. And then now we'll go back and add some red in those stripes here. Here. And a little bit of blue right in there. And now, oops, I want that white to dry. Ah, shoot, I smeared it. I didn't realize that had slipped. And add my red. Let's see, I bet I can fix that. Doctor it up a little bit. What do you guys think?
How cute.
Oh, look, I can just kind of paint back over that.
These smaller craft journals would be so fun to do like a monthly gratitude journal, and then you could decorate the covers.
For the whole month?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'd be so cute. Let's see, I need a ruler. Don't want to smear that paint again. I better move it. I better learn from my lesson, right, guys? Not the hard way. Oh, I think I cut that too short. Dang it. Let's see. Nope, that is what I wanted. Okay. All right, now I need a little bit of red paper. Let's just grab. I just want to add a smidge of red on there. So again, this is just Diana's. This is her Western pack, but it's so cute.
It's really fun for the 4th.
Okay, will you find me some twine?
Thick or thin?
Thin. Yeah, that's gonna be so cute. I think I wanna... You know what, you guys? I already added my chalk ink and stuff, but you can totally still trim this down and then round your corners again. This is why you don't need to be a perfectionist when you're crafting. Because you can really wing it. Yep. Now I'm much more happy with that. Cute. Let's glue this part down with my tape runner. Again, this tape runner is from a Lindsay Doodle Kit.
That's where a lot of our paper crafting tools have.
We have loved those. And then you can add a little bit more chalking if you desire.
Sally says, hi, ladies. I've missed you.
Well, hi, Sally. We're so glad you joined us today. Okay, so there we have that. If you wanted to round the corners on that, you could to match. That's totally your preference, whatever you want.
Our precision scissors, also from a doodle kit.
Yep.
You need the link to sign up.
Let us know. Yep. I think we're going to be discontinuing her lettering kits, so But the doodle kits, they're still going if you haven't signed up for that. And they have just as good of stuff. I just love adding twine and ribbon and things like that to my paper crafting projects. Dun da da da, so cute.
Lindsay says, hey, Lindsay checking in.
Hi, Lindsay. We're so glad you're here. We're doing your cute July calendar girl stamps, and we've made a darling journal using your cute stamps. Because we all know it's my favorite month, and these stamps are to die for. Look how cute. And then we have our July down on the bottom. Glue that down. Oops, we're out of tape. We're gonna have to get a new runner. There we go. Throw that in the garbage. Okay, I'll have to finish adding that. But look how cute, you guys.
Super cute.
So cute, right? And I love that Posca pen down there, even though I accidentally smudged my lines. That's okay. So very, very cute. And then if you want to make this like a cute gratitude journal, like Miranda said, or write notes in it or make it like a planner, then you can take all these cute additional stamps, you guys, and stamp them inside and keep on having fun. So the possibilities of being, having all this fun artistic stuff is endless. Okay, I love this 4th of July stamp right here. Cute banner up here at the top is so cute.
Perfection.
So fun. You could make a mini scrapbook and add pictures in here. I mean, I could just keep going with ideas. So fun. Or, like I said, if it's somebody's birthday month, make them this cute journal for their birthday month. And how adorable would that be?
Super fun.
Anybody would love that. So, okay. That is the reveal of our Calendar Girl Stamp Club. So thanks for joining us today. Miranda's readjusting the camera.
Coming back.
So thanks for joining today for our Calendar Girl Stamp Club. Again, enrollment is open if you want to sign up. If you haven't signed up before, today was a sneak peek. So if you sign up the month of June, you will receive this stamp for the July stamp. It's calendargirlstampclub.com is where you can go. We also have that 4x6 add-on club, which has a ton of cute coordinating stamps. So all of that is available.
Yes. I've got to share Michelle's idea. She said adding all of your July recipe books or recipes into it and making a cookbook. So if you added all your favorite barbecue recipes,
so cute.
And then you could gift that or just keep it for yourself.
And keep it for all your summer
so
salads,
fun.
All the fun things that
you
can barbecue with. So cute. I love the idea. So fun. Okay. All right. Calendar Girl Stamp Club. Any of the additional items we use, we sell. They're all available in the link. I feel like there's something else I wanted to talk about. Calendar Girl Stamp. Oh, my hat. Lindsay's cute art. So we have our cute embroidery hats that are available now to order. You'll get the cute denim hat and Lindsay's cute flag heart. What was it called?
USA Love Hat.
USA Love Hat. If you also need embroidery floss, you can choose the complete kit and it will include the floss that you need as well. So we did a fun demo on this. Was it last Wednesday? Last Friday. It was
Friday.
Freedom Friday.
Yep.
So last Friday we did, if you go back to our videos, we did a demonstration on how to make this cute hat as well. So, okay. Well, you guys, thanks for joining us for our first Tuesday of the month to show you the preview of the Calendar Girl Stamp Club. Thanks for joining.